Now let us move to the next attribute, which is Al-Adl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just. And this is why He has created the whole universe with justice. And by justice, what I mean is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created a balance in the universe. And this balance shows us that everything in the universe has been given a balance. وَالسَّمَاءَ رَفَعَهَا وَوَضَعَ الْمِيزَانِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised the heaven and He has placed a scale into it, a balance into it. So in the very same way, we human beings are asked to create that balance in our life. The only difference between the objects of the universe and ours is that they are operating with the balance. But we are given a free will, and because of that free will, we are told, take that book, Al-Quran. That is the balance for you. That is a sharia for you. And this is how you can create a balance and harmony in this in your life. Let us take this ayah of Surah Al-Hadid. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ وَأَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدَ فِيهِ بَأْسٌ شَدِيدٌ وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ وَلِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ وَرُسُلَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ We have sent our messengers with clear evidences, and we have revealed with them the book والميزان and the balance. Book and the mizan. So this mizan is the sharia, which is taken from the book itself. So لَيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ So the people could handle their affairs with justice. That is what is required from us. Everything is in this universe is created with the balance. You can see all the different objects in the universe. They are running very smoothly because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted them to run smoothly. In the very same way, you should have a smooth life as well. And I always say, especially when there is a wedding taking place and we have to give some nasiha, admonition to the new couple, I mentioned this ayah or this dream of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. إذ قال يوسف لأبيه يا أبتي إني رأيت أحد عشر كوكبا والشمس والقمر رأيتهم لي ساجدين He said to his father Yaqub عليه السلام Oh my father, I have seen in my dream 11 stars and the sun and the moon all prostrating to me. Now when this dream came true after so many years, how it did come true? That his father, his mother, of course at that time, that was not his real mother, that was his aunt, Yaqub alayhi salam, has married her. And his 11 brothers, all of them, they came when he was in Egypt and they prostrated in front of him when he was sitting on his throne. This is how the dream came true. So who represents the sun and the moon in this dream? The father and the mother. Or you can say the man and the woman. Or you can say the husband and the wife. Now look at the sun and the moon. They are just rotating in their orbit. Sun is not interfering with the orbit of the moon. The moon is not interfering with the orbit of the sun. Because if they interfere with each other, that would be the last day of this universe. There would be a great havoc. Everything is going to be turned topsy-turvy. So this is why we say that the same thing should be adopted by us. We human beings, husband and wife, father and mother, man and woman, you got your role to play in this life. A husband got his role, a wife got her role. And as long as you stick and abide by your role, inshallah, there would be no trouble in the house. The trouble only comes when each one is going to interfere with the role of the other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the man the harder task and the woman the other task, which is also very hard, and that is to rear the children, to take care of the children, to bring them up. That is not a very easy task. This is also a very hard task. But because of their tender nature, it is good for them to remain with the children and rear them and give them a good upbringing. This is a great lesson which we understand from this ayah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned another ayah, وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَلِلْرِّجَالِ عَلَيْهِنَّ دَرَجَةً. The woman got the very same right as those duties which are upon them. And in comparison to the duties, they got some rights as well. Don't deprive them of their rights. If they got the duties, they got some rights as well. And if there is a rank which is given to the men, وَلِلْرِّجَالِ عَلَيْهِنَّ دَرَجَةً, that rank we know, that is to spend on the household and to get your livelihood, to earn your livelihood. That is understood from the ayah of Surah An-Nisa. But anyhow, we come to the end of this program here. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.